All right, we just got this video in that shows the moment of all of this in Port Authority near Times Square. Let's go to our Bryn Gingras. Bryn, can you walk us through what we're seeing in this video?
Yeah, I mean, this is going to give you a good idea, Poppy, of what we were talking about throughout the morning, which is that narrow area, that narrow passageway mm-hmm. where this detonation took off. You can see this is coming from a surveillance camera somewhere within the Port Authority, and right there is when you see the explosion, and you can see that there are still even people walking toward the right, running to the right, but then you see that person that's lying there on the ground. Now, I can only assume that that there is the suspect, or it's possible it's one of the people that was injured throughout this. We know earlier from that news conference that those injured had ringing of the ears and some headaches, so I can imagine that that was there, the suspect who we're told to authorities had that detonation device on him. But that is the exact moment inside the Port Authority, that narrow passageway where this went off.
And again, as we're looking at this video, and I'm not sure whether the former commissioner, Matt Horace, still with us right now. But Matt, if you are with us, former ATF official right now, as you see the picture of what certainly appears to be the suspect on the ground there, leveled out after this device went off, but still, you know, not to be too gruesome here, his body still fully intact. It's unclear to me whether this device went off with the impact that he intended it to. Matt, are you still with us?
I am, and I think the answer to that question is no. If he intended it to injure multiple people, dozens if not hundreds, and we see the condition of his body, clearly the device did not go off as he intended.
Commissioner, to you, just explain to people who aren't familiar with the New York City subway system. First of all, it's essentially like a sidewalk, but it's covered on all sides, and it connects two avenues or different parts of the subway. But explain to people just the lack of, there's nothing you go through when you walk into the subway. I mean, there's no metal detectors, nothing like that.
No, there's really no metal detectors. I mean, if they operated a system like you have in an airport or anywhere else, you'd get nobody into the system. You know, there's,
right.
You keep in mind there's millions of people that go through the system. But Poppy, I want to touch on one thing that Matt said earlier, and that is there may be other devices out there. You know, I've heard some political pundits say there's no specific threats right now in the city or in New York. You know, there is a credible threat to this country. It may not be specific to New York City right now, but there is definitely a credible by ISIS, Al-Qaeda, and these other radical Islamic groups, this guy being one of them probably. And, you know, just to that point, people have to be extremely careful, cautious, vigilant, pay attention to where you are, pay attention to the people around you, especially at this time of the year when somebody like this would try to make an example out of New York City.